It fit him. For us, we might have to find another path, but for Bruce Lee, that was the path he chose. Things that Bruce Lee did, and this is what people don't realize, what he did, a lot of people can't do. Like, he could really shell-shock a person with his Lee jab. A lot of people can't not. We could score with that. We could put the guy off balance with it. We might even hurt him, but we can't take a man out. He had tremendous power, and we don't have that, you know? And then there's people, if you want to, they'll say, I study Aikido, I study Jiu-Jitsu, I study Karate, I study Taekwondo. I'll put it together and I'll call it Jeet Kune Do. Is it Jeet Kune Do? It's Jeet Kune Do for them. So I would say that if you did that, put Karate and Aikido and Taekwondo and maybe wrestling, that could be your Jeet Kune Do. That's correct.
Sifu Jason here with Greenville Academy Martial Arts. Thank you so much for watching. Today's subject is a big one, and I want to be careful with it because we are not bashing the great and venerable master Dan Inosanto. He has done an incredible amount of good in the world of martial arts, and you know, is just a fantastic gentleman and a wonderful representative of so much of what is needed today in this day and age where, you know, it's very hard to get everybody to get along. And he's a great ambassador for goodwill and knowledge and for consistent seeking of improvement. That being said, what we want to talk about is an error he makes that has massive ramifications for our understanding and our personal development in Jeet Kune Do that we think educationally will impair and impede your personal journey towards self-defense efficiency. So what is it exactly? Is that he starts from a premise that's flawed. The premise is, he says that Bruce Lee could kill people with his Lee jab. He could knock guys down. He was like a little Marciano, he says. And then, ready? Yeah, that's, I think it's true. Bruce hit extraordinarily hard for his size. Then he says that, well, you can't do that. We can't do that. So we can't do Bruce's personal Jeet Kune Do. And so now we need to go off and do a bunch of different things. We need to go and do BJJ and Muay Thai and, you know, John Wick, dead dog avenging, Russian mob boss son killing, Rick Grimes zombie shooting, and, you know, Jedi saber fencing, everything. We have to get all of these things under our control so that we can find our truth, so we can absorb what's useful, reject what's useless, and add what's specifically our own. There's nothing wrong with cross training in arts. So many of us do it. The problem is in thinking that that accumulation of stuff is going to make you a good self-defender. That was actually the opposite of what Bruce Lee was doing. Just because you and me or whoever else cannot hit as hard with a lead jab as Bruce Lee did, doesn't mean we can't use the intercepting fist method. In fact, it's actually incumbent upon us to do that, to make sure we don't complicate things because we don't have those attributes, if that makes sense. Think about it. If Bruce could hit, let's say, a 12 gauge and you're shooting a 9mm, it's still effective. You know, we talk about a level of degrees here. You should get good enough. If you use the right structure, you should be able to land a strike that's going to stop them. Or it's going to, if that doesn't stop them, you can move, hit them again, hit them a second time. You could do that twice. You may need to then, and add what's specifically your own, you may need to use more defensive cover. You may need to slip more or parry more or move a little bit more than Bruce, but you don't need to completely jettison the system and the fighting method itself and go into completely contradictory systems. And I don't mean that those systems are terrible and they're evil. I just mean that the goal and the structures of them are different than the goals and structures of Jeet Kune Do. And putting them together is no good.
Myself, if I was a person interested in getting better in the martial art, I would study under a good Wing Chun teacher because I do think it's important. I would study under a wrestler because I believe they're in highly conditioned. They know how to understand sensitivity from another perspective. I would study a Filipino martial art and study things like the hubad, things of that sort, because it's only going to make you well-rounded.
Ted Wong told me one time we were having a bite to eat, and he said, you know, you wouldn't put pizza with chocolate in so many cases. A lot of things you wouldn't just mix together. Just adding something doesn't necessarily make it better, right? We know that in our personal lives, right? Like, for example, in your marriage, if you add another woman, that doesn't necessarily make your marriage any better. It kind of complicates things, and it probably attracts a divorce lawyer at some point. You know, adding a bunch of extra things to your self-defense is a catastrophic mistake, because what you need is you need brutal simplicity. Don't complicate things, especially if you don't have more attributes than the other guy. You have to simplify them. The goal should always be simplicity. And if you can't hit as hard or as fast as Bruce Lee, the last thing in the world you want to do is now make your stuff more complicated. And you listen to the Inosanto interview, and he's got so much informed things to say about different systems like Muay Thai and Savate and so on. And that's all wonderful, but it's complicated. And that takes a lot of time to learn all of that stuff. And you're supposed to absorb what's useful, reject what's useless, add what's specifically your own. You're not going to have anything to add because you're going to be broke. You're going to learn all these different systems. You know, the idea is simplicity. And because of that flawed premise that you're not as strong as Bruce, you're not as gifted physically as Bruce, so therefore you can't do what Bruce did, he then adds a bunch of complication to it.
I would say that a lot of people were saying, well, the most common comment I hear is that, well, Danny Inosanto has muddied the waters of Jeet Kune Do because he teaches other arts. So I don't think there's anything wrong with that. If you like classical music, you should be able to go into pop. You should be able to go into Western music. You should be able to go into hip-hop or whatever you like. I don't know what you like. And I don't think there's anything wrong in liking classical music and pop music or Western or jazz or whatever. I think that's a person should be able to do that. In other words, it would be like, okay, I eat Italian food. I like it. And it is good, and that's all I'm going to eat. And that's okay, too. But you should maybe eat something else besides Italian food, no matter how good it is.
I think that's the central error in the Dan Inosanto philosophy that is that will infect you and prohibit you. It will impede you from learning to use a very simple and efficacious system of the intercepting fist method. Just think in terms of boxing history. Look at the different ways the jab is used by different boxers. Jim Driscoll, Jack Dempsey, Joe Louis, look at Ali, look at Liston, look at Foreman. The way Foreman wasn't very fast, he pawed and he jammed up the forward line so people had to go around them, and that's when he nailed them, right? So Foreman was able to out-jab faster jabbers because of his tactics. That's what it means to have no way as way. That was the genius of Bruce. Not that he absorbed all of these different martial arts over like a couple of years of research. It was that he knew exactly what was essential. So hear that, absorb what's useful, you know, in this context. If you hit, you hit really hard, you might not need to slip as much. You may not need footwork as much as the next guy. You may be able to carry your guard in a little bit of a different way. You make slight adjustments. It doesn't mean to try to absorb a bunch of different systems that are, in many cases, contradictory to one another, and then assuming that's your personal Jeet Kune Do. That is a misidentification of those facts. So, once again, in summation, I hope this helps because I love this system and I love watching people get better. Don't throw it out. Don't jettison the intercepting fist method because Dan Inosanto said, you're not as strong as Bruce. You absolutely can do it. You just would have to do it a little bit differently. And then lastly, think about it. If Bruce is shooting you in the face with a bazooka and you're hitting a guy with a .45, they're still just as dead. They're still just as injured. Just because we don't have Bruce Lee-like attributes doesn't mean we can't get Bruce Lee-like results. Other people have done that in so many ways. So hope this helped. I know this is going to open up a can of worms. People are going to get mad at me just because I had the audacity and the temerity to say that Dan Inosanto was mistaken with something. We're not calling him bad names. I'm not criticizing the man. No ad hominem. It's completely on the philosophical and logical extension of those ideas. It's philosophy 101, boys and girls. If you start from a flawed presupposition, you're going to end up with a flawed system. And the flawed presupposition is that since you're not as strong and fast as Bruce, you can't do Jeet Kune Do. You can't use the intercepting fist method. You have to do something different. And then you have to answer the question, why is adding complexity going to help somebody who doesn't have outstanding physical attributes? Which is what I think is a real problem for it, is that it leads you, the trainee, the student, thinking, I've got to learn more martial arts for me to find my truth. No, you have to be specifically brutal and simple with the basics. And you can do that. Even if you can't do it like Bruce did, you can still do it. You can find a way to do it. That's our message for you. I hope that's helpful. Again, the spirit of this isn't to be mean to anybody. The spirit is to try to educate the folks out there, because I know there's a lot of confusion out there. I hear it a lot, and I hope this is taken and received in the manner that it is extended. We'll see in the comments and questions. I use no ad hominem attacks, and I use logic with it, and hopefully I was respectful. If I made a mistake in that, I apologize. I know that Mr. Inosanto's reputation precedes us, and he deserves all the respect he gets in that regard. And I try to extend that to him, even though I say I think that he's wrong with this particular idea. So that's my spiel for today. Hopefully it's educational. Please let me know your thoughts in comments below. And if you do, click the like and subscribe button. You can exercise your finger. And we look forward to hearing from you. And I'm sure this will be a robust debate. So thanks for watching.